spring, you have to take off the sweaters for the bikini. That's dismantling at the deepest level. Well, maybe not the deepest level, but a threatening level. Dismantle also means to raise or to destroy the fortifications around a city. God is coming to dismantle us. And I wonder if that isn't what Advent is for, to dismantle us of our false selves, to help us see in our inmost self what we truly long for. What we truly long for, knowing that God is truly longing for us. In the past, I've always been one to get overly exercised about Christmas decorations going up too early. But last night, as I was traveling through a little neighborhood right near here, I actually took a lot of delight in the decorations. It said to me, Jesus is coming, look busy, or get quiet, or dismantle, but prepare, be alert. That's what it said. Be alert, as our reading says, to be alert. Now, the people with the robes Santa Claus in their front lawn, I am sure, are not thinking, be alert, for Jesus is coming. But it's what it said to me, to be alert, to be ready, to be prepared, because I very well may be dismantled during Advent. I wonder what dismantling looks like in your life right now. I know what dismantling looks like in some of your lives because I've heard about it. But what if there was just one thing that we could do differently? One thing differently that would say to God, I'm taking apart some part of my life so that you may have greater access. Whether it's lighting an Advent wreath or taking time for one caring conversation a day with a family member or a neighbor, to reverence them. To reverence them. I wonder what it is like for a mom or a dad or a grandparent to reverence a teenager. And I wonder what it is like for a teenager to reverence their mom and dad. Reverence is part of what we want to instill in our worship during Advent here this year, because we know full well that there is lots of dismantling going on, and we want church to be a safe, quiet, and reverent place where we can come for just a bit during the week. One of our newcomers came to me and said, you know, I visited a lot of churches, and then I showed up at your church, and do you know why I came back? It was the reverence I experienced in your church. And I said, us? At the beginning, and man, you're kidding me. And she said, no, no, yes, yes, yes. So we will endeavor to incorporate a little more silence and a little more reverence during Advent. A little more silence after. Now, in the old days, they used to go out and take a wheel off the wagon to make the Advent wreath. You take a wheel off the wagon, hang it in the hall, the greeter around it, the candles. How much more can you dismantle your life than to take the wheel off the wagon? Take a wheel off the Chevrolet. That will slow you down. And that's what we need to do during Advent. Slow down, be quiet, be reverent. Because in fact, God, the coming one, will dismantle us. We will find there a great, great gift. Our true selves. The selves that we were created to be. The selves that will welcome them, the one who is to come on that dark December night. At that second coming, when he comes again, and as he comes daily into each and every day.